There's a whole fleet of them. Look on the ASA.
My gosh.
There has been an uprise in interest in recent years for life beyond Earth.
A whole fleet of them, look on the ASA.
Of course, footage of unidentified aerial phenomena has contributed to that enthusiasm, and we are glad that even NASA has commissioned a panel to investigate UAPs. But we shouldn't hold our breath while waiting for fuzzy video footage to yield anything exciting. However, we should definitely explore every opportunity that may lead to an answer for one of the biggest questions in human existence. Are we alone?
So what we now know from looking for exoplanets around distant stars is that most of these stars, I'd say, to first approximation, all of them have solar systems and planets around them. The current estimates for the number of Earth-like planets in a typical galaxy like the Milky Way suggest that maybe one in 10 stars has a rocky Earth-like planet, the right distance from the star to support, potentially, to support oceans and therefore possibly life. That means that we estimate there are about 20 billion Earth-like planets in the Milky Way galaxy alone.
When searching for possibly habitable exoplanets, it helps to start with worlds similar to our own. Many rocky planets have been detected in Earth's size range, a point in favour of possible life. Based on what we've observed in our own solar system, large gaseous worlds like Jupiter seem far less likely to offer habitable conditions, but Earth-sized planets in wide orbits around the Sun like stars are much harder to detect. Life on other planets might be like nothing on Earth, but it makes sense, at least at first, to search for something more familiar. Life as we know it should be easier to find, and that's why astrobiologists focus on habitable zones, which are the distances from a star at which liquid water could exist on orbiting planet surfaces. Habitable zones are also known as Goldilocks zones, where conditions might just be right, neither too hot nor too cold for life to exist. One such world that could have potentially hosted life is a planet in our very own solar system, Mars. Billions of years ago, the red planet was habitable when it had lakes and rivers of liquid water on its surface. There have already been a few studies that have used radar observations to show that reservoirs of liquid water probably exist a couple of kilometers below the surface, strengthening further the idea that Mars used to be habitable and possibly hosted life.
A geologically active region of Mars, it's called Tharsis, the Tharsis Rise, heavily volcanic. The large volcano you see in the middle of this image is Olympus Mons, which is the size of France, the biggest volcano in the solar system. So we know that Mars was geologically active. It had active geochemistry. We also know that it was wet at some point in the past. Certainly, 3.8 billion years ago, the same time that life was getting a foothold here on Earth, the conditions on Mars were very similar. In fact, even rather more benign, we think. So Mars is a planet that shared the same conditions as Earth when life began on Earth. So that may suggest that we might expect to find that life had begun on Mars. That's something we can test, and we are trying to test now. So we're looking for the evidence that life did exist on Mars, or perhaps evidence that it still exists, because we again have strong evidence that the water on Mars did not all escape to space. Some of it went underground. There's certainly ice on Mars, and we have reasonable evidence there are pockets of liquid water below the surface on Mars. So it is not beyond the realms of possibility at all that there are Martians today, or that there were Martians in the past.
Even more interesting than finding out if Mars used to host life is to find a world where it hosts alien life today. Possible candidates in our own solar system include the moons of Saturn and Jupiter, Titan and Europa. In the coming decades, we will explore these moons that may have a definitive answer if they do indeed host life. Going beyond our solar system, we may even find evidence for life as we don't know it. While looking for habitable planets, astronomers often look for planets of similar size, mass, temperature and atmospheric composition to Earth. But astronomers at the University of Cambridge believe there are more promising prospects. Only discovered recently, a new class of exoplanets dubbed Icing planets could harbour bizarre extraterrestrial life forms beyond the bounds of our imagination. These Icing planets are very different from Earth, but could support life, which could significantly accelerate the search for extraterrestrial life outside our solar system. The Icing Planets are hot, ocean-covered planets with hydrogen-rich atmospheres. Compared to Earth, these planets allow for a far wider habitable zone, or Goldilocks zone. This means that they could still support life even though they lie outside the range where a planet similar to Earth would need to be habitable, making us wonder if the probability of life existing elsewhere is much higher than we thought.
What's the probability of there being life beyond Earth in, let's say, a typical galaxy or even a solar system? The answer is we don't know. We only know of one world where life exists. But it is interesting to look at the history of life on Earth, because the history of life on Earth can potentially tell us something about the probability of finding life elsewhere. What's interesting about the history of life on Earth is that it arose pretty much as soon as it could, after the Earth had formed, when the Earth cooled down after its formation. And we certainly have evidence that there was life present on Earth 3.8 billion years ago, and some evidence that it extends beyond that, maybe to 4 billion years. So that's pretty much as soon as it could. Now, if you think what life is, then life must be the transition from geochemistry to biochemistry. That's what we mean by the origin of life, because you start with a world where there is no life after its formation, and on Earth you ended up pretty soon with a world where there was biochemistry. So we have an idea that essentially carbon chemistry gets more complex in the presence of what a physicist would call gradients, or so temperature gradients, pressure gradients, alkaline and acid gradients, and so on. So this idea, there may be a sense of inevitability about the increasing complexity of carbon chemistry in an active geological setting, such as a young planet, is a hypothesis, but it can be tested, potentially, if we're lucky. So one of the sections is to try to look at other places and explore what we know about other places where those conditions existed, and indeed may exist today.
Many astrobiologists think that if life exists elsewhere in the universe, the vast majority of it exists in the form of single-celled organisms, such as bacteria. And intelligence, if it exists at all beyond Earth, is extremely rare. Hopefully we'll find evidence for any life form when we start to explore space, starting with our own cosmic backyard, the solar system.
It is certainly true that on some of the moons of Jupiter and Saturn, in particular Europa, one of the big moons of Jupiter, and on the smaller moons of Saturn, Enceladus, it is true today that the conditions that we think may have led to the origin of life on Earth, which is liquid water in the presence of active geology, those conditions exist today on some of the moons in the outer solar system. So if that hypothesis is true, that there's some sense of inevitability about this transition from geochemistry to biochemistry, if we're lucky, we might be able to verify that by finding evidence of life on Mars or the moons of Jupiter and Saturn. That doesn't answer when we start to ask these questions about what it means to be human, the value or otherwise of humanity across a civilization in a typical galaxy, that does not answer the question, how likely is it that there are complex, multicellular living things? If we find life on Mars, it will be single-celled. There is absolutely no doubt about that, we're sure. But what we really mean when we say, you know, when we ask questions such as, are we alone in the universe? What we really mean is, are there places where there's complex multicellular life, and indeed things that can think, atoms that can contemplate atoms, which is a rather poetic description of a human being, but it's surely true. Well, again, we only have one example. I always say, actually, that what's the most remarkable thing about our planet? It tends to be our instinct to say, well, it's the beautiful rivers and the forests and so on, the diversity of life on Earth. That's certainly true. But if you were an alien flying into the solar system from elsewhere, the thing you would notice in the solar system would be the city lights on this planet. That is the most surprising and interesting phenomena in the solar system. It is our civilization.
Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.